Hey guys, welcome back to the shop. Frank here. I got some hoses. All right, the Napa shop here actually turned these around in like 24 hours. I told you I would share with you the cost. I predicted it was going to be $700. I was way off. It was less than half of that. It was $330. Right there for all the hoses. $330. So I'm a surprise. So I obviously way overestimated the cost. And I'm thinking back to the hoses for the dozer. I mean, it was $1,000 by the time I got done with the dozer. The motor grader was $600 or $700. Now those hoses were longer. Matter of fact, some of them were much longer. So maybe that's, you know, the difference. I'm thinking that the end connections are the major cost, but maybe the hose is a big deal, big part of it too. Anyway, $330. The Napa store, they didn't have all of the connections they needed, but they ordered them, got them overnight, made the hoses the next day, next morning. So, it's a great shop here, so I'm happy. Anyway, all right, we're going to get started on putting these on the tractor. So that's the next task. So you'll run into different types of fittings on these cylinders. A lot of them are going to be these O-ring, SAE O-ring fittings, but you're also likely to find pipe thread fittings as well. Looks like the O-ring is still there. I think that's actually 11/16. Thank you. Okay, so then you got to make a decision on which side of the spool to attach this to. So this is the top of the cylinder, so putting fluid in this will push the lift down. So that would be down. Well, normally that would be up and this would be down. So if that's down, then that's going to push the spool down. Since this is pivoting up, it should push the spool down, which should put fluid in the bottom. Be down, this is up. Okay. That's up. All right, so up will be here. Tighten this one up. So those hoses will be covered by the fenders, and I'll secure them underneath there. Other side here is the same drill. Well, who's coming here? My Butchie. Yeah. No, that's Brew Brew. That's my Brew Brew. Even I get them mixed up sometimes. Leave that loose till I get the other hose on. We'll do that. measuring these hoses, you usually give them an extra inch or two because you don't want to have them too short, because then it's, you got to make an extension or remake the hose. So, and I'll fasten all, I'll manage all these hoses. I might have some wrap to put on them, or at least tie wrap them underneath the tractor. Loosened up a little bit. I think they're all tight. So I've already run the other hoses, the suction from the tank goes underneath the starter motor and goes to this side of the pump. This is the suction side. I did crank the motor over, put my finger over the input. I could feel a little suction here. And this is the discharge. So this line comes out and goes to the valve. And then the other side of the valve from here comes down to the back to the tank. Okay. So looks like we've got all of the lines on. I don't see any risk of interference between these hoses and the clutch or the belt. I think we're good. Let's throw the fenders on, make sure there's no issues with the hoses. I have a little bit of interference here with the hoses. I'm trying to think of the best way to deal with that. All right, I just need to push the connectors in a bit. just the hose is interfering, but that's fine there. All right, so that fits. A little concerned about that because it's hard to tell, but yeah. I think we're good. Okay. I do have this one fitting to tighten up though. There's my boo-boo. What a good boy. You're all wet. It's raining outside again. That's a good boy. Get some hydraulic fluid. I have a 5-gallon jug of it someplace, maybe in the garage, and we'll fill the system. I'm going to leave the front bumper off here in case I need to tighten up any of these fittings or adjust the belt or anything like that. So I'm going to replace this fuel line. This is ancient and it's falling apart. So these tractors, you really don't necessarily need a fuel filter because there's a very fine filter screen inside the back together, ready to go. You can see this fuel line was pretty bad shape. The top part was fine. I probably replaced that 5 years ago. For some reason I didn't replace the other piece. Okay. Yeah, we're back in business here.
So I took my microphone off. I took my sweatshirt off, and I've been working on this without my microphone. It's been on my sweatshirt sitting about 10 feet away. So sorry about the sound on that. I can hear bubbling like it's draining. Maybe it's draining down to the pump. Oh, maybe into the filter too. Sure. It's only supposed to take a quart and a half. And it's taken probably 2 quarts so far. Forgot to tighten these. Turn the engine over. Let's take it out of gear. That drew some fluid out of the tank. Actuated the spool valve, I saw the tank level go down, so it's pumping fluid. I need to bleed the system is the next step, is to open the valves while the engine's cranking. I just lifted the cylinder, knocked the camera over. It was underneath the lift arm. I opened this, and so it pumped fluid in here. Lifted the arm right up. All right, well, that's a good sign, right? Good sign, okay. All right, that's the first round. We'll come back a second time. Let's try the other cylinder here. Let's see, I got some fluid out of this one already. This is the one. So that's got to be the up function. More fluid. So we fill the cylinders and lines, draw the tank down a little bit. All right. So the quart and a half reservoir plus the system took about almost a gallon of fluid. All right, I got the battery set up here temporarily. And, well, there's my brew. What you doing, huh? You being a good boy? You being Dave's good boy? Yeah, okay. No, don't go out there. You stay inside. That's a good boy. Okay. There's Brutus checking out. I got the door open because I'm getting ready to start the engine. You're such a good boy. You know that? What you looking at? What you looking at? What you looking at? Yeah. Give me that paw. There you go. Okay. Look out now. Go on. So I said I got the battery installed temporarily. In trying to start it, I discovered my starter relay is not working. So I'll just jump it with this until I get that replaced. Don't know what the problem is with that. I have another one.
Properly.
Okay, so I'm happy with what's going on here.
Thank you.
All right, that's just primer. We'll paint it yellow after this dries.
All right, guys, I think that rates as a successful first test of the three-point hitch and hydraulics. It worked exactly as intended, so I'm happy about that. Really no issues other than the belt on the hydraulic pumps get stretched a little bit, so I'm going to get a slightly shorter belt. Kind of anticipated that. It was at the end of its tension adjustment, so I need to do that. I'll do that. Everything worked as planned. No issues picking up that rear blade that I have for my Kubota. And with this tractor, I can actually put down force on the blade. Normally you use those blades just in a float function. So I need to figure out how to do that. I know there are float valves. So I may wind up going that route. I have to see about that, because I know I have used bush hogs, 5 foot bush hog on a farm tractor, a utility tractor. And of course, you know, it probably needs to float in order to follow the terrain. So I do need to address that. I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet. Maybe it's just a float valve, or change out these valves for valves with a float function. So we'll see what happens with that. That'll be something down the road. Meanwhile, we'll come back next week working on the bush hog. I've got the gearbox. We'll talk about some design parameters and make some progress on building that. It's going to take several weeks, so I hope you stick around and watch that. If you enjoyed this episode, it'd be great to if you would subscribe if you haven't already, or leave a thumbs up. Hit the notification bell if you want to stay up to date on upcoming episodes, and leave a comment. I'd love to hear your comments. I read all the comments. A lot of good suggestions, so I appreciate it. All right, so we'll see you next week. Happy New Year.